right here in front of your people. See, time is money, kid, and BS walks. And to me, it's funny, kid, when you meet heads talk. I see feds talk. They wanna dig up the dirt, son. Is it me they hawk? Cause I be putting it work,
gonna
son.
Gonna be on tit up. That's all my eyes can see. Victory is mine. Yeah, surprisingly, I've been lame. Waiting for your next mistake. I put in work and watch my status escalate.
Your cornballs get stonewalled, blackballed. I own y'all. The veteran running my plan. I'm the better man. Crazy raw, doing my job like the mob. Blazing y'all and disappearing in the fog or a mist. And chicks can't resist what I kick. They be begging for attention or some more of the deals, Nick. Word up, baby. Someone may have to get hurt up, baby. Shit is mad shady, but I got to get the gravy. Platinum respect like the force of a tech. Keep you hitting the deck, feeling heat in your chest. Banging your thoughts with the hot onslaught. A kid got shot on the spot for going where he should not. Viciously, I make history instantly. Those other lame ass loser ass niggas, they can't fuck with me. I'm doing my thing now to lamp later on. Paid in the shade with some fly gators on. But now I'm grimy as they get, mud on my pants and shirt. I bet you niggas out here know I be putting in work.
I'm gonna be on tit up. That's all my eyes can see. Victory is mine. Yeah, surprisingly, I've been laying. Waiting for your next mistake. I put in work and watch my status escalate.
I had the opportunity for this camp to go to Las Vegas, Nevada and train at Floyd Mayweather's gym. A friend of mine, Walt Big Ticket Harris, UFC fighter, is friends with Jeff Mayweather, Floyd's uncle, and was able to, you know, set up some training while we went to Las Vegas. And it was a dream come true. I got to train directly one-on-one with Jeff Mayweather, and you know, one of the biggest attributes of Floyd, I feel like, was his hand speed. So, you know, that's what I went there mainly focused on. Got to do a ton of pad work with Jeff and work with the team, and also got to do a ton of sparring. Got to spar with some of Floyd's best guys that he signed himself. And, you know, put in a lot of work and a lot of training when I was there. You know, I'd wake up every morning, run to the gym, and it was awesome. Sparring with these guys, you know, that are undefeated as professionals, you know, big time in boxing. And, you know, I'm in there competing with them, doing really well. It gave me a lot of confidence going into my last fight. American Top Team, Coconut Creek, the best gym on the planet. The first time I went in there, seeing all the faces and the posters on the wall of all the champions was super motivational. You know, they put in place all the best coaches, which brings all the best training partners. And it's everything, I mean, it's a fighter's dream, everything you could ask for. Every day I get to go in there and, you know, learn a ton. And there's just a ton of knowledge. Like, anytime you look over to the left, you look over to the right, there's someone there that can make you a better fighter. And it's just up to me to utilize these people, and I've done so far, you know. Ricardo Laborio, Charles McCarthy, Matt Welch. There's a ton, the list goes on of all the coaches and training partners that are there. Teamwork is a big thing for me too. A lot of people think fighting is just a one-on-one thing, but for me, you know, it's a team. We're a family there. We have a lot of training partners and people we all put together, and we learn from each other. I mean, the coach is obviously there to coach us, but I've picked up a ton of stuff just from my training partners and my friends there, just doing our own thing. And this is something that, I mean, it's awesome. That's why I train. Strength conditioning is another thing that I added in for this camp. Believe it or not, I've been training for 5 years now, and my conditioning was never a problem, so no one ever really felt the need to focus on strength conditioning. I mean, I rode my bike a lot and did it on my own, but you know, I'm not a professional with the strength conditioning. I just know, you know, how to get in shape by running and riding my bike. So, you know, I listened to my manager, Charles McCarthy, and he thought it'd be a good idea to get him some strength conditioning. So we got in touch with some old friends that I trained with back in the Boca gym, Adam and Sam, and we, you know, they set up training at Raw Fitness, which they've been doing really well with. And it's been, you know, it's only been for like a month or two now, but I feel like I'm starting to get stronger, and it's great, you know. Last but not least, obviously, there's the guys that I started training out with in the beginning. You know, my coach Matt Welch, Angel Cruchado, Daniel Campbell, Matt Waggy. There's a lot more guys, you know, but it's just these people have grown with me as a fighter, and that's what I feel like the sport's all about. And it's awesome to have them in my corner and to continue them, everybody being there. So I'm just going to keep it up and, you know, keep going with it, and hopefully they can grow with me. Come on, we're almost done. Let's just finish this. Once you're done with this, all you have to worry about is your food, buddy. I think chicken parmesan will be delicious. You're gonna get to get as much water as you want. And this guy is the guy that made you lose these extra pounds for no reason. I like the look you got going right now. That's like a look Chucky Russell would pull off.
It is. Good luck tomorrow. Kick his fucking ass.
Nice. What was your last name again?
Leech. Peter Leech. Peter Leech. Jimmy Leech. He knows me very well.
Okay.
I'm gonna come and check you out.
Hey pal, what's going on, Charles? Hey, how much is the guy gonna be over realistically? Alright, I'm not worried about it. So let me call Jimmy right now and then like I'm not gonna have Rosa cut anymore. I'm just gonna leave him.
You're being recorded right
now.
You gotta cut that one out, buddy.
I am shaking in my boots.
How much?
Yeah. What round do you think you would finish me in? You think I'd make it to the second?
All right, first up, let's go. Charles Rosa, Delray Beach, Florida. 52 and a half, Charles Rosa. Next up on the stand, Steve McGee.
What it is today. It's the real, real. It's the pressure.
Charles Rosa, you see now, warmed up, warming up, making his way to the cage. Charles Rosa is an American top team fighting out of Delray Beach, Florida. Holds a professional record of 4 wins and no losses. 2 knockouts, 2 submissions, so the man knows how to finish a fight. And you have Philadelphia Fight Factory fighting against American top team. Once again, 2 of the very best schools around. CES not joking tonight.
As you watch the fighter get prepared and thank his corners and get Vaseline'd up to go into the round, you'll notice there's a banner in the hand of that gentleman right there. Recently, American Top Team was credited with coming up with the idea of the banner.
I heard that was like the first banner sponsor, etc.
Correct. Apparently it started off, they used to hang their flag.
Over the fighter on the way in.
Over the fighter on the thing, and then eventually that, as the flag got too beat up and bloody, and the UFC started to protest.
Yeah.
They switched over to these sponsors, but it's funny to watch how
it's evolved
at every level. Yeah, absolutely.
Well, there's a lot of fighters out there that can thank American Top Team for getting sponsors on their banner. And again, American Top Team, if you've lived under a rock or never heard of MMA, I can understand you don't know who they are, but if you have any passing interest with MMA, American Top Team, one of the best in the game. Just an onslaught of fantastic fighters at every level. So you have a 4-0 fighter coming from American Top Team flying up from Florida to work with us tonight.
He weighed in at 152 and 1/2 pounds, hailing from Delray Beach, Florida, introducing Charles
looks like a more of a Taekwondo stance, very bladed, bouncy stance.
Reminds me a lot of Steve Thompson. Steve Wonderboy Thompson.
Oh, nice left hand. Great straight punches pouring it on. Fantastic job by Charlie Rosa. Then he hits the single for a takedown.
Starts to deliver some damage and some strikes to get him active.
Right back to it, then, too.
Exactly. Recapture the neck.
He jumped that. He's looking at it. Is that a 10 finger he's trying to put
it's
on?
It's a version of a Peruvian necktie.
Wow, it's an inverted Peruvian necktie. I don't know how else to explain that. Do you have a better?
That's exactly what it was. A Peruvian necktie. He rolled through a little bit. That's you could see he was setting it up. He was very patient with the move.
Yes, he was.
And like I said, anytime your head is tied up, you should stop and notice.
Ladies and gentlemen, take a good look at the last two fighters you just seen. Andre, the Asian sensation, Sokomoth, and Charles Rosa. Might not see them around here too much longer. Both these guys are doing phenomenal work. Charlie Rosa just improved his record to 5-0 with two knockouts and three submissions.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Kevin McDonald stops the bout at 1 minute 39 seconds of round one. Your winner by Peruvian necktie submission. Hailing from Delray Beach, Florida, Charles Rosa.